New day, new lecture, and new marks. Welcome to the world of SMAT quickies. Guys, we're going to take a complex topic today, simplify it, give you a nice shortcut, and help you solve a complex problem that is there at both CA Inter and maybe at CA Final Stage too. Income from salaries is one thing that people don't enjoy, and what people don't enjoy, I really enjoy, so that I can simplify it for everyone who finds it difficult. My attempt is from income from salaries today. Guys, in income from salaries at CA Inter and maybe at CA Final also, there is something called voluntary retirement scheme and voluntary retirement compensation. A little about that scheme first. Who doesn't want to have a nice life, take a job up and voluntary retire, get some money and then do something on their own? And for that, there is a scheme called voluntary retirement scheme. Example, you're working in a bank and the bank, let's say, had manual entries earlier and now it's computerized. So they don't require so many people. So they go to the government, they get a scheme approved, which is called the VRS scheme. And they ask people, whoever wants to take that scheme, it's voluntary, and that's the name voluntary retirement. And if the employee wants to take up the scheme, they take up that scheme. There are certain rules and regulations, like you should have served 10 years in an organization before you can take VRS. Also, you should have been in the 40s, you should be in the age group of 40 or above to take VRS, etc., etc. But these rules, honestly, are not asked in the exam. What is asked is the calculation of how that money that when you get on voluntary retirement, that voluntary retirement compensation, how is that taxed? And we're going to deal with just that today in a very, very nice shortcut. Wait for it. Welcome to SMAT Quickies. So just summarizing, where are we? We're talking about this chapter called salaries. And in this chapter, we're talking about voluntary retirement scheme or voluntary retirement compensation. Now, guys, a couple of things. You should be in your 40s or 50s or 60s to have this retirement compensation received. Next is you should have completed at least 10 years of active service in an organization to be eligible for VRS. Also, guys, if a company gives you a VRS, it cannot be forced. It's voluntary. And once they give you a VRS, that same position cannot be filled up again by the company. So they cannot remove you and then take someone else. And you cannot be employed under this another company or the same management. So you cannot be employed again in the same management. Of course, you can take up another job somewhere else. So these are some conditions you should keep in mind in case CA Inter MCQs ask you these. But guys, the main and the more important question is, how is the compensation tax? So let's say when you retire or voluntary retire from an organization, this is voluntary retirement, you get a check of, let's say, 8 lakh rupees. They say, congratulations, here is your 8 lakh rupees check. And this is, guys, the last payment. There are some shortcut words here. So please remember, in VRS, of course, this is the last payment because you're leaving the organization. So this is the last payment they are making to you. And when you leave, guys, what happens? Whenever you leave an organization, you feel bad, right? You see what has happened behind and you see what has happened ahead. So you see behind and you see ahead. What do you see behind? How many years you've completed? So how many ever years you've completed, you'll see behind you. And how many ever years are left, you'll see ahead of you. So that's what it is, guys. You'll see a little ahead, you'll see a little behind, and then you'll leave the organization. This 8 lakh rupees has been received. So is this a benefit, guys, in the hands of the employee? In your hand, is it a benefit? Yes. So you will first add this 8 lakh rupees. So the voluntary retirement compensation, just like any other compensation, is first added. So I'm going to add the 8 lakhs. In the exam also, whatever amount they give you, first add it. And then you say less. You have an exemption, guys. You have an exemption under a section called 10, because exemptions are 10. And here it's 10C. 10C, because you see ahead and you see behind, and hence it's 10C. If you've been my student, guys, we have an entire pattern of shortcuts for all these retirement benefits, but because I'm teaching you only just one, so then 10C is an exemption section. Guys, 10C. You see ahead and you see behind. Now, what is the exemption? It is least of some amounts, guys. It is least of the following amounts. Let's see least of which all amounts they're talking about. They say least of the following. Let's say which least of the following. First is whatever voluntary retirement compensation you've been receiving. So you received 8 lakhs. So you'll put 8 lakhs here because that is the amount that you received. Second, guys, B is a statutory limit. This statutory limit is the maximum amount the government can afford to give you as an exemption. So they put a statutory limit, which in this case is 5 lakh. Guys, this is not an example. This is the actual amount, standard amount. In every VRS question, you'll have to plug in 5 lakhs. Now, guys, for C and for D, the calculation, the first calculation is the same. You have to see the last salary drawn. The last salary drawn. How do you remember it's the last salary or average salary or last 3 months salary, guys? last salary, because VRS means you are leaving the organization. So I told you last is a shortcut. So last salary drawn. And in salary, if you've been my student, you know the shortcut. But if you've not been my student and you're watching this for the first time, guys, salary everywhere in the salary chapter is BDC. BDC is salary everywhere unless there's something else specified. So BDC is salary. What is B? B is basic salary. What is D? D is that part of dearness allowance. In our shortcuts, D is that part of dearness allowance, which is in terms of retirement benefits, which is used to calculate retirement benefits. And what is C? C is that commission, which is a percentage of turnover. So if they give you a monthly commission, this is not that. This is that C. C is only and only, which is a percentage of turnover. So you have to calculate the last salary drawn. Again, I say, guys, last, because it's a VRS, you're getting the last payment from the company. So hence the shortcut last. Next, salary is always BDC, basic. Dearness, but which forms part of retirement benefits, and commission, but which is a percentage of turnover. So BDC you'll take and you'll multiply it by seeing behind and by seeing ahead. When you see behind, what do you see? You see completed years. So you take the completed years and you multiply it by 3. So you see behind and what do you see? How far you've come? How many years you've completed in that organization? So you take the completed years and you multiply by 3. And when you see ahead, what do you see? You see that you have about 6 years left now to complete till retirement, till official retirement age, you have 6 more years. So compute that 6 years and multiply it by 12, because we want months, not years. So that is, let's say, 72. All I'm saying, guys, is 10-10-C. You see behind and you see ahead. What do you see behind? How many ever years you've completed and into 3. People get confused. Completed years, rounded off, not rounded off. Nowhere it is rounded off except gratuity and retrenchment, where you know it is. Otherwise, guys, everywhere it's completed years. So if you've completed 22 years, or let's say you've completed 22 years and 9 months, it's still going to be 22 years only. So completed years into 3 when you look behind. And when you look ahead, how many years left till retirement? 6 years or 8 years or 9 years? How many ever years into 12? Guys, multiply it with both these numbers and the least of the four will be your number. I repeat, guys, VRS, how do you get? You understand that it's an income for the employee? Yes, it is. So you will add it? Yes, that's the first step. You add it. Will you reduce an exemption? Yes, you will reduce an exemption under section 10-10-C, because you have to see behind and you have to see ahead. Least of the following. First amount, whatever you receive, that's amount. That requires no calculation, guys. It's easy peasy. Next one, statutory limit. The government says the statutory limit, that is the maximum deduction or exemption they can give you here, is 5 lakh rupees. So that one. And the third and fourth, guys, are based on one calculation only. Last salary drawn. Salary is BDC, last, because it's VRS, and the last payment that you'll be receiving. Into, you look behind and how many years you've completed into 3 times. And you look ahead, how many years you've are yet to be completed into 12, because you need the number of months there. And guys, that least will be allowed as an exemption. Let's do a quick sum so that we can put into practice what we've just learned here, guys. Mr. Datta, employee, has received voluntary retirement compensation of 7 lakh. Guys, I'm not even looking at the question. I'm just going to start. So what I will do is I'll add this 7 lakhs, under which head, of course, income from salaries, because it's coming from your employer. And I will write less exemption under section 10-10-C. And of course, you know, least of the following. So let's see which least. The first is voluntary retirement received. That is 7 lakh rupees. You don't need any working for this. The second one is a flat 5 lakh statutory limit, which you already know. So guys, we are halfway through the sum and we have not yet done any reading for the sum. Let's see. After 30 years and 4 months. So that's, guys, the completed number of years of service. He still has 6 years. So when he looks ahead, he has 6 years left, and he looks behind, he has 30 years gone. At the time of voluntary retirement, he was drawing a basic salary. Guys, the moment you see basic salary, you can put B. B is 20,000. And dearness allowance, which forms part of pay, that means forms part of retirement benefits. So that's the D we are looking at. That is 5,000. There is no percentage of turnover commission. Good. So guys, our BDC is 25K, the last BDC. Now, guys, we can do C and D both. For both C and for D, we have the same number, that is 25,000. Because that's the last salary drawn. When you look behind, how many years do you see? 30 into 3. And when you look at how many years is left, 6 years into 12, that is 72. You guys get all the numbers, 25,000 into 30 into 3. This is 22,50,000. And 25,000 into 6 into 12, 25,000 into 6 into 12 is 18 lakhs. So you've got all your four numbers. All it is now is the least of the following, guys. 7 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 22 lakh 50. Or 18 lakh, 5 lakh is the least of the following. So you will minus 5 lakh. Thankfully, up to 5 lakh, they are not going to tax you here. And the 2 lakh, you will have to pay tax under the head salaries. But of course, if you've been my student, you know salaries is only SAP minus SEP. For that, we'll see another video, guys. But this is how VRS calculation is done. Guys, VRS is something that you'll find in your exam because they give you a sum that you had a job, you left the job, you took VRS, and then you did something else. So VRS is a very, very common thing in practical life, but even more in your CA exams. Guys, SMAT quickies, I hope this one is going to help you score some really good exams in case VRS comes up. All the best and see you soon.